Hi, this is Jacob with PCTechGuide.com, and this is part 4 in our video series of how to speed up your slow computer, because there isn't just one reason why your computer's slow. There's probably multiple reasons, and we're just covering all the basic ones. So in the description below here on the YouTube channel, we do have our YouTube channel in there for how to speed up your slow computer, and all in that video series there, we're going to list several different ways. So be sure and check out the other videos too as well, because chances are it's not just one thing, it's several things slowing down your computer, and in each video we're going through just one quick way of speeding up your computer. And this one, this is probably going to be one of the more important videos that we do, and it's going to cover Startup Manager. So when your computer first starts up, you have all these auto-starting programs. And so if we look in actually the system tray down over here, we're going to see that there is a lot already in there. Now, every program you install nowadays pretty much wants to be in there. And you know, back in the day, it was Kodak Easy Share was the number one software that everybody had on their computer, but nobody ever used. And for you, it might be Skype, you know, whatever that program is, that you probably have a lot of them. So the number one thing I'd recommend is to hit the Windows Start button, go into the Control Panel, and then go to Uninstall a Program, and go through all your programs and just, you know, uninstall the programs you're not going to use anymore. And we're going to see that, hey, I got quite a bit of them in here that I just installed this in my last video, which I'm going to uninstall now. And, you know, I don't need it. And CCleaner does auto start on me, and it does auto try to get an update. So, you know, go through, and if you're not using the software program anymore, you know, uninstall it. And this is actually going to help free up a little bit of disk space too as well, which is nice. And you know, it's something I need to do, is I need to go in through here and delete all the programs I'm not using anymore. Once you remove these programs here, they won't be auto-starting on you anymore, because they just won't be installed anymore. Now, not all programs you're gonna want to eliminate. So you're like, well, you know, I definitely still use, let's say, Skype, right? But I don't want it starting up when my computer starts up, because I just don't use it that often, but I do use it. So you know, in my case, I use it every day. But, you know, this is just an example. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to the run command here. I'm going to type in msconfig, C-O-N-F-I-G, and go ahead and hit enter. And so what this is going to do is it's going to bring up the system configuration menu. So I am going to go to startup, and it's very important that you don't really touch these other services, because you can really hose over your computer. Now I'm going to go under the startup menu here. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to go through these and uncheck the ones that I know for sure that I don't want auto starting on me. And some of these you're going to be able to easily tell what they are, and other ones you're not going to be able to tell. Now what you don't want to do is just uncheck everything, disable all, because some of these are going to be needed services for your computer to start properly. However, you can go through and make a pretty estimated guess and saying, well, you know what, this one says unknown, it's NVIDIA Corporation, I know that's my NVIDIA update, right? So it says NVIDIA update core. And so you can go through this and take a look. And this is what a lot of, like, this is where a registry cleaner can help you out. And we do have a link in the bottom of the description. Besides our YouTube channel, we have a link to a registry cleaner reviews here that you can check out. Now, I don't use registry cleaners really to clean the registry. That's kind of a thing of the past, to be honest. But it can be used to really easily gauge which programs shouldn't be auto-starting, which ones can be. So in my particular experience, no, I don't really care about the updater program there. I just don't need it. Adobe updater startup utility, yeah, kind of, you know, Adobe needs to be updated. So I'll keep that one. But you can go through this and say, well, you know, I have all these Adobe ones in here. Do I need them all? And just go through and let's say, okay, well, I don't use Dropbox really that often at all. I don't really care about the Google update. I update it myself. I don't use Andy anymore. I don't use Dropbox. So you can go through this and Samsung Electronics, that's going to be for my phone for when I sync. Hopodge and WinTV. I uninstalled these cards years ago, but this stuff's still in there, right? So if I uninstalled these programs, they wouldn't be there anymore. But let's say, well, I might reinstall that card, so I want to keep it, and I want to keep Dropbox, but I just don't want it auto-starting on me. So I'll go ahead and keep that and hit Apply, and then hit OK. So right now you're going to be asked to restart or exit without restarting. In this case, I'm going to just exit without restarting. When you do restart your computer, I do recommend you just go ahead and restart it now. Now, when your computer boots back up, it's going to come up with another dialog box telling you that Windows configuration has changed. Just hit the, like, don't show this message again, and then hit OK. So that's when your computer restarts. It's just letting you know that changes were made. In this case, I'm going to go ahead and hit exit without restart because I'm not restarting my computer. Just yet, anyways. So that's it for this video. It was fairly easy to do, and optimizing your startup menu is probably one of the things that's going to give you the biggest boost possible in speeding up your computer. So definitely spend some time on it. Go through the uninstall programs, go through the startup menu, and pick which programs you really don't want auto-starting on you. In the next video, we're going to be covering defragging your computer and just trying to help it out a little bit to optimize it. And that will be in the channel URL, so feel free and take it a visit. If you like the video, if it helps you out, please go ahead and share it, like it, comment it, whatever you do, right? It all helps. Thank you.